The simplest built-in backup feature available on your Mac is Time Machine. To use it, you need an external hard drive connected to a USB, Thunderbolt, or FireWire port on your Mac. The beauty of a Time Machine backup is that it keeps hourly, daily, weekly, and monthly backups of your entire Macintosh hard drive. That's all your files, folders, installed apps, settings, user accounts, and the way your Mac looked in the past in order to restore them later. Setting up Time Machine is as easy as 1, 2, 3. 1. Purchase an external hard drive. 2. Connect the external hard drive to your Mac. And 3. From the auto-loading Time Machine pop-up window, click the button Use as Backup Disk. And your Mac backup procedure automatically begins. Seriously, it's that simple. Perhaps the hardest thing to do on your part is deciding on the type of hard drive and storage space needed for your Time Machine backups. To ease your dilemma as to the storage space needed, generally get an external hard drive double the size of your current Mac internal storage. Once the external hard drive has been purchased, simply connect it to your Mac. Usually, when connecting a new blank external hard drive to your Mac, you'll see the following auto-loading Time Machine setup window, asking if you want to use this hard drive to back up with Time Machine. Simply click the button Use as Backup Disk and you'll be presented with the Time Machine Preferences window. Alternatively, if the blank hard drive was formatted differently, then you'll see the following window after you click the button Use as Backup Disk, asking if you want to erase the backup disk. Click the Erase button and again you'll be presented with the Time Machine Preferences window. If you don't see the pop-up Time Machine setup window after connecting your external hard drive, then simply launch System Preferences and click on the Time Machine icon. Then, click the button Select Backup Disk. Click once on the name of your external hard drive, in my case the name is Untitled, and then click on the Use Disk button. And like before, you're presented with the Time Machine Preferences window. Therefore, assuming you've reached the Time Machine Preferences window, you should notice the next backup will start automatically in 120 seconds. This is entirely up to you. I prefer to manually start my Time Machine backups, so I'll uncheck Start Automatically and then check Show Time Machine in the menu bar. When ready to start a backup, simply click on the Time Machine icon in the menu bar and select Backup Now. The first backup could take a long time, depending on how many files you have. You can continue to use your Mac while Time Machine backs up your Macintosh hard drive. Future backups are faster, as Time Machine only backs up files that have changed since your last initial backup. Once Time Machine has finished the first backup, you'll see the following notification. Optionally, I'll rename the external Time Machine hard drive appropriately, Time Machine 1. Again, this is entirely up to you. I generally eject the Time Machine disk and manually initiate a backup of my Mac every 2 weeks. I'll now show how to restore specific items deleted from my pictures and documents folders on my Macintosh hard drive. I'll just delete everything in my pictures and documents folders as shown. To restore these items, I'll just connect my Time Machine disk and from the menu bar, click on the Time Machine icon and select Enter Time Machine. On the bottom right hand corner of the screen, you can scroll through the timeline for the date and time you last did a Time Machine backup. Use the on-screen up and down arrow to jump to the last time the contents of a particular folder changed. I'll just click on the Pictures folder and use the up and down arrow to locate the items that was in the Pictures folder before they were deleted. Once located, simply right-click or control-click on an item for additional options, or press the space bar to preview the selected item. I'll just select all items in the Pictures folder and then click the Restore button here. As you'll notice, the items in the Pictures folder has been restored to the Macintosh hard drive. Repeat to restore the deleted items in the Documents folder.